Hi, this is Rick, and you're in the Whisky Zone, where we celebrate the spirit of the spirit. You know, it seems like distilleries expand their offerings every other day, but when an Islay mainstay adds to their core range, well, I say it's worth a look. This time around, it's the Wee Beastie from the Ardbeg Distillery. I'd like to point out that I'm wearing my Monsters of Smoke Tour t-shirt, which I picked up when Ardbeg marketed this whiskey across the US last year with their very hard to miss Monsters of Smoke truck. Now, when Ardbeg released the Wee Beastie in 2020, I personally thought it'd be a one-off experiment that we'd see for just a short time. But I was wrong. It is a part of their core whiskeys. It takes a great deal of confidence in your stock and a repeatable flavor profile to announce to the consumers that they can expect to find this product on the shelf on a regular basis for a long time. And that's what they've done. This 5-year-old newbie has been matured in ex-bourbon and Oloroso sherry casks at 47.4% ABV. It's been released with no chill filtering. But I have to tell you, I get slightly annoyed when they don't think it's important enough to state that there's no color added. Just a heads up to Ardbeg, it's important. But I will say, when it's in the glass, it's this very pleasing light gold. So it's obviously spent more time in the bourbon casks. And the legs have a very nice, long, oily viscosity. So let's see what the nose has to say. I'm getting the infamous Ardbeg smoke, followed by medicinal iodine, as if there's another kind of iodine. And now a sweetness. I'm picking up brown sugar, vanilla, paint, enamel paint, linseed oil, wood. I'm getting woody, but more specific than that, it's like a cavernous dunnage warehouse. It's got to be at least 50 years old, that deep embedded wood smell. More smoke. Back to sweet, maybe some maple syrup and some ocean air. But as we all know, the true test is on the palate. Ignore the first one. Ash, or an ashtray, which is kind of a strange thing to say because I've never actually tasted an ashtray before. A full-throated bourbon barbecue sauce. Burnt spices, or a burnt rubber smell. No, forget that. It's not that bad. Chocolate-covered prunes. And those little chocolate squares. You know, the strong ones with at least 85% cocoa. At less than 48% ABV, I'm digging the not-so-overpowering smoky flavors as they are. So I'm reviewing this one with no water added. But feel free with your bottle. The finish on this one is fairly long. There's definitely a little spice, a weird one, kaopectate, don't ask, bitter chocolate, and the remnants of an Ashton Heritage Dominican cigar. All right, I know that was a little too specific, but you get the idea. It's gritty in the mouth. One of the things I really appreciate about this whiskey is not only its flavor profile, but its price point. Releasing a decent young whiskey at an affordable price is an occurrence that seems to be getting harder to find these days. Good on you, Ardbeg. Sure, it's young, but it has its own kind of maturity in a very drinkable way. I feel comfortable giving the Wee Beastie an 8-finger pour. I hope you've enjoyed this review of Ardbeg's Wee Beastie. If you'd like more details on my review, please visit thewhiskeyzone.com. And while you're here today, I encourage you to comment, like, subscribe, and share. So until next time, drink smart, stay safe, and we'll see you again in the Whiskey Zone.